Hello guys, this is Samir Wadkar and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So guys, in my last video I said that from now onwards I'm going to take your queries and I will post answers in the form of videos. So guys, I'm going to continue this question answer series. So what you have to do is, if you don't know, you have to post your queries and I will give them answers in the form of videos. So let's start this first question answer series. Institute Kota ke rounds kab hote hai, kab admission Institute Kota ka start hota hai? That's it, right? Many of you might be having this question that when Institute Kota rounds will start, when this offline admission will start. So let me tell you guys, now you will get, after some days you will get MSc CET results. After that you have to fill form for MSc CET CAP counseling process. After that MSc CET will release results for CAP round 1, CAP round 2, CAP round 3. So I just want to tell you here that Institute Kota rounds also start with the CAP round rounds only. What do I mean by that? Like, they take place simultaneously. Means, like, first Institute Kota round 1 will start. Okay. Then after, your online CAP round will start. Then you have to take the admission through Institute Kota round 2. Then you will get online CAP round 2 results. Then after that, Institute Kota round 3 will be conducted. Then after that, you will get your CAP round 3 results. And after the CAP round 3, if the college has still vacant seats, they will conduct further Institute Kota rounds, like Institute Kota round 4, 5, whatever they want. Okay, so one sentence answer for your question is, like, they both take place simultaneously, your Institute Kota rounds and your online CAP rounds. So guys, our next question is, does institutional quota has EWS reservation or other caste reservation? Do we get fee waiver or fee concession in if we take admission through Institute Kota? So let me tell you guys, in Institute Kota, first of all, there is no caste reservation. It is open for all students and there is no partiality. Here you get admission purely based on your merit. If you have higher percentile, your merit will be high and you will get admission first. So if you are from a reserve category, if you are from SC, ST, OBC or something NT to something caste reserve category, and if you get admission through Institute Kota, then you guys have to pay full fees. Then you will not get fee concession over here. So if you want fee concession, you have to take the admission through online CAP process, online admission. So guys, our next question is, if I apply for Institute Kota, can I still go through the online CAP round? So guys, answer is yes. I will tell you by giving you a good example. So let's suppose you get DJ Sanghvi College through Institute Kota. So you applied for Institute Kota, you got the DJ Sanghvi, and after few days you get your online CAP round 2 results, and in that results you get to know that you have got admission in VJTI. So you will be going for VJTI. So in that case you will select the seat from online CAP round and you will cancel your admission from your Institute Kota. So don't worry about that. Even if you have paid full fees, you will get refund from DJ Sanghvi, and the same fees you can use for getting the admission into the VJTI. So here guys, you can see this comment. Basically he is asking whether he has to pay full fees or half fees. So can he pay less amount during the time of Institute Kota admission? So let me tell you guys, Institute Kota rounds are very strict when it comes to the money, because college wants money. So if you are giving them full money, they will give you a seat at a time on the spot. Okay, so I have seen those students, I have seen many cases, and this thing happens every year. Even if you have good percentile, your merit is high, but just because you don't have full fees with you, you will not get the admission at that time. Your seat will be given to other student, even if his score is less, but he has full fees with him. So guys, on the time of Institute Kota admission, you must have full fees with you. So he's asking, like, is the Institute Kota legal and do they ask hefty fees along with it? So I will try to tell you here that what is actually Institute Kota. So guys, see, in Maharashtra Engineering Colleges, if you want admission, there are two ways. First, online CAP process, and the second one is Institute Kota and Management Kota or Management Kota. See, so what is the difference? Like, 80% seats are reserved for online CAP process. So that seats you will get with the CAP counseling online process. And the second one is Institute Kota or the Management Kota. These 20% seats are in the hand of college itself. Okay. So these 20% seats are reserved for the Institute Kota. So your answer is Institute Kota legal. So your next question is that do we have to pay donation or something like that? Almost most of the colleges, they don't ask for your donation. So institute quota means you get admission there on the basis of your percentile, on the basis of your merit rank. So if you have good percentile, if you have good merit rank, you will get admission in the institute through your institute quota rounds. So you don't have to pay in a single penny or donation for to get admission through institute quota. But there are some colleges, they do ask for donation for offline admission as well. So we cannot say like it is institute quota. There is a separate term called management quota, and there are few colleges, I will not take the name of that colleges, they ask for the donations and they ask lot of money from you to get to give you the offline admission. In that case, even if you have very low score, let's suppose 20% L, and if you are able to give them like 14 lakh of donation, they are going to give you like the top seat of computer science, information technology, etc. So these are called management seat, management quota. So guys, I received these many questions only. So here I would like to talk something more about institute quota admissions. So guys, I will tell you the reality basically. So in institute quota rounds, like you have to be very active with the dates. Like you should know like on which date there is institute quota round for this college. There are a lot of colleges that are conducting institute quota online for this year. So you have to keep eyes everywhere. Okay. So in institute quota round, basically if you don't have any idea, so first of all you have to fill the form for institute quota. So in particular college, they get like there are thousands of students who are applying for institute offline admission. So you have to pay fees, like there the form fees around 1500 to 1800, some college has 2000 rupees as well. So once you fill the form, after some days that college will release the institute quota result list. So in that list you will get which merit you have got, so what is your rank in all those 1000 students. So if you have 99 or 100 percentile, you will be at in top 10 students. So your chance of getting admission first is very high. So basically in institute quota you get merit, and on the basis of merit you get the admission. So what they do basically, if they have 1000 students, they call each individual by their merit rank. So merit rank number one come, which branch do you want? So yeah, you want computer engineering, go for that. So this is how the colleges fill their offline seats with the help of institute quota rounds. So do apply for institute quota rounds, and if you have many other queries related to the institute quota rounds, do let me know in the comment section, because I know you still have some queries. So I hope you have enjoyed this question answer series. So what do you want in the next video? So do let me know in the comment section. Please post your queries. So that's it.